They're having kids teaching kids at Dubbo public school today. We get to listen to other kids teach us and get to teach others.
In the preparation for our Kids Teaching Kids workshops, our schools have had a lot of support from local community organisations. Here at Dubbo South Public School particularly, we've had a lot of support from local land services Central West, as well as the Office of Environment and Heritage for professionals to come in to classrooms working with our students, imparting knowledge and skills and ideas so that our students become expert learners. In other schools, I know companies, Grain Corp, did a lot of work with sustainable grains. And the kids were highly motivated and engaged to find out from people in the field just what it is they can do to make a change in their environment. Within the workshops on the day, lots of hands-on activities. And again, children teaching their peers how to become a catalyst for change. Our today's learners becoming tomorrow's leaders. It's been a really exciting day. There's been lots of buzz in the air. We've hosted a range of schools from across the Central West. Schools as far as Neville, down near Blaney, around the Dubbo Group area, Forbes and Parks. We've had a range of workshops presented, including permaculture, worm farming, feral cats, nesting boxes and habitat loss. And it's just been a great day.
Welcome to today's session on permaculture 101. What is today's session on?
Up straight, eyes this way, and we don't want to be missing a thing.
The vital question is, what is permaculture? I brought on some very special guest speakers for today to help us answer this very important question.
Excuse me. Permaculture is the ability to live a sustained life. This means living without needing to go to all the cost of food, not needing to go to the butcher shop for meat, being able to grow and live from the land.
Anyone?
Anybody who contributes? I've got some red oak rocks. So just gonna chip in. So I'm gonna bribe your kids. So if you ask a question, you get a chocolate, or if you know an answer or something, or have a contribution, you also get a chocolate as well.
Are they even real eyes or glass?
Yeah, glass ones, yeah, just to make them look real. Real ones are gonna be mushy. Really. So, I've got 9 questions here,
and they'll lay 1 every 5 to 7 days for the season. So if you say, so that's about 25 weeks, isn't it? So one egg a week over about 25 weeks. Then at the other end of the incubation period, they start hatching out.
Yep, they hatch separately.
What happens is the male fowl, the chick is down here. See, we go, end of the day, and he's piled it back up again. So the chick will burrow up through the leaf litter, basically shift the leaf litter from the top to the bottom and gradually come to the top, and then there's no parental recognition at all, no parental recognition. Sometimes the mallee fowl don't get back to their mound to monitor the temperature because what can come along. Foxes, there's a couple of foxes. Right, now foxes come in and chase the mallee fowl away. Come on, quick, chase the mallee fowl. There's a mallee fowl, and where's the other one? There she is there. And sometimes, so the foxes prey on the mallee fowl.
Bye. Well, I've learned that feral cats and domestic cats and stray cats all kill birds and native wildlife and stuff like that.
I really like the nesting places one and how we learn about nesting boxes are used as lost their homes from like getting the wood from trees from paper or stuff like that.
But I'm here today at the Dubbo South Public School Kids Teaching Kids Conference. And Kids Teaching Kids Conferences are an ideal opportunity for kids to learn about the environment and sustainable farming practices, but also importantly to teach it in their own words to their peers. And that's the way they learn best. My presentation today is about the threatened species, the mallee fowl, which lives right across the arid zone of Australia in the remnant mallee vegetation. And they've learned today that foxes kill mallee fowl and prey on mallee fowl. And that they can encourage farmers, to help the mallee fowl, they can encourage farmers to leave some of their native vegetation intact and to control foxes right the year round, not just when it suits them for lambing season.